everyone. Welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me this morning is John Savin from Proactive Research. John, how are you doing today?
Hi, thank you.
Good to hear. So John, today we are talking about the note that you recently published on Tiziana Life Sciences. We're focusing today on the licensing deal that Tiziana had announced between Precision and Tiziana. So tell us first about Precision and what they focus on.
Yeah, Precision is a genetic engineering company. It's doing some activities in rare diseases, but a lot of its focus is on producing allogeneic CAR T cell therapies. So that's where they are modifying T cells, growing them up, and ideally the product will be off the shelf, or actually in the freezer, available in hospitals across the country so that somebody comes in with a particular cancer, they can be treated very quickly. It's a new area, it's really hot, it's a big area of development, lots of people are interested in that, and it's, you know, assuming it works, it will be a very big market. Currently, products are autologous, which means it's customized, one patient, one product, one manufacturing operation. It's very, very expensive, and there's quite a high failure rate in the manufacturing process. So going to an allogeneic product, as Precision Biosciences aim to do, is the way forward ultimately.
Before we get more into the details of the licensing deal, just remind us what Tiziana has been developing its therapy for foralumab to treat.
Yeah, the product with Tiziana is being used in a very interesting way because it's been delivered to the nose or in a capsule to the gut. And that's so that it affects mucosal immunity, and that will modulate the immune response in conditions like Crohn's disease or multiple sclerosis, or at least those are the indications it's in development for. We've yet to establish late stage clinical data on these products yet. But those are very interesting applications, and it's a very interesting delivery route. The product that they're licensing to Precision is an injected or intravenous form of that drug. So the two markets are completely different.
So now talk us through how Precision will be using Tiziana's therapy in CAR T-cell therapy.
Yes, so when you are going to have this patient have CAR T-cell therapy, you have to go to hospital some days beforehand to have your immune system reduced. The reason for this is that when you put the CAR T cells in, these very expensive genetically engineered cells into you, they need to grow and expand. And as they do so, they'll attack the cancer cells. We get more excited, they grow and expand more. So this gives you an effective therapy. But if you don't reduce your immune system cells beforehand, the therapy really doesn't take hold properly. So this process called lymphodepletion is currently done by a combination of two highly cytotoxic drugs. It's known as Cy-Flu therapy. And some patients just can't tolerate it. It's just so toxic. So the idea is that by using the Tiziana antibody, they will reduce the immune system down in a much gentler way, but an effective way. Now, we need to see the clinical data on this. It's currently just an exploratory project. We shouldn't over elaborate it. But it's an interesting idea because if you can use a more gentle approach to lymphodepletion, and bearing in mind that we're going for allogeneic therapies, which is a much broader group of patients, then you know, you need a more acceptable lymphodepletion therapy before you can really expand this out to a greater number of patients. So it's a very interesting approach. It's exploratory. But it has huge potential. And if allogeneic therapy takes off, you know, this could be a major sort of option for clinicians to use.
Yeah, just piggybacking off of that, in your note that you had said that this licensing deal could potentially create long-term value for Tiziana. Why is that?
Well, it's an area they're not currently in, and it's a very, very big market. You know, there are about a million cancer patients a year in the United States. How many of those will eventually benefit from allogeneic CAR T-cell therapy? I can't say. Currently, it's a handful of patients only in certain blood cancers. But as I say, it could become the obvious standard of choice for many patients eventually. And because we're talking about an antibody, it's very difficult to complicate it to copy it. This whole biosimilar route creates problems. and you anyway have 12 years biological exclusivity with the FDA. So you know, if it, this goes into a major market, allogeneic T-cell therapy, which is starting to really develop up in 5 or 6 years' time when this might come out, they have 12 years exclusivity on it after that point. So it could be a significant amount of money. Now, they are going to get a royalty on it. We don't know the royalty amount, but it could be a major value added to Tiziana over the long term. And the nice thing is it doesn't cost them any money. They get money, some upfront fees and milestones for the development, but it doesn't cost them anything to develop it.
Well, we will certainly look forward to following the story. John, really appreciate your insights today on Tiziana. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.